International, India's largest solar media organization. Joining us is Mr. Puneet Mehta, Director of Pixel. Hello, sir. Welcome to the interview. My question to you is, how much product has your company supplied in the domestic market so far?
So basically, we started somewhere around May-June 2021, and it has been around 4 to 5 months now that the module manufacturing facility has been running. And we have been able to cater of around 26 to 27 megawatt till day. We have been supplying to many of the government tenders and to few of the private players, and we have our own dealer network wherein we are supplying the modules currently.
So what will be your target for the next year?
So in the next financial year, we will be launching our new new set of modules. That will be half-cut higher watt peak modules, namely M6, M10 and M12. And it will be up and running from around June-July 2022. So then we will be expanding up to 1 gigawatt. And of course, the target will be much more higher compared to this year, because it will be higher watt peak capacity. And next year, financial year target will be around 250 to 300 megawatt that we would like to grab the market from.
That is very promising. And what about your long-term plans?
On the long-term plan, as you know that the Atmanirbhar has been ongoing, the BCD is going to be in place, and we have made up the facility of around 65,000 square meters, so wherein we'll be able to accommodate around 3 gigawatt of module manufacturing, EVA manufacturing, and a few of the other components like aluminium frame and backsheet. So we are planning to go ahead with a few of the raw materials. If the market turns out to be of glass module, then of course we won't go ahead with the backsheet plant. But other raw materials will surely be in place with us. And on the longer term basis, we would like to be a gigawatt player.
Okay. You just mentioned BCD. With the coming and revised BCDs, what do you think will it be beneficial for manufacturers like you?
Of course it will be, because the BCD that has been implemented is 40% on modules and 25% on solar cells. So solar cells being 50%, around 50 to 55% of the complete BOM, it will be around 12.5% that will be effectively implemented on the domestic produced modules compared to what has 40% what has been procured from China. So if you look at the price on the pricing part, the Chinese will be facing a big hit in terms of the replacement demand that is being substituted by the domestic module manufacturers.
So that will be that will give companies, especially the indigenously developing companies, an upper hand. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Whenever we are talking about manufacturing of modules, durability is a very big factor. So is there any solution that you have devised to enhance the durability of your modules?
So basically, if you look at the solar module components, then EVA that plays a vital role in the durability of solar cells and backsheet, because it is the bonding component between solar cells and glass on the front side and solar cells and backsheet on the rear side. So basically, we have came out with a solution to develop our in-house EVA. So we have gone ahead with a German equipment vendor, and with the European technology, we have been able to achieve very good results, and it is one of the best in class EVA that has been produced by Pixel domestically. So EVA is one thing that I would like to share, that it will enhance and will secure the durability. Again, on the durability part, there are certifications based on the stress testing of modules. So each and every module has been certified and stress tested at our end. We have got certifications from TUV and we have got our BIS, ALM certifications. So based on those certifications, the durability will stand to be what is promised.
Okay. Was this technology indigenously developed? And how much part of the R&D was taken from the company?
See, basically, nowadays each and every company needs to invest in R&D, because new technology keeps on coming. There are upcoming technologies on the module side. Previously, we used to have full cell modules. Nowadays, half-cut modules are in place. The higher watt peak modules are there. On the EPC side, there are tracker system that has been developed, bifacial modules, glass to glass modules has been a new trend that will be upcoming in a couple of years. So each and company needs to spend around 2 to 3 to 5% on R&D each and every year. We, being a new company, along with the introduction of EVA plant and few of the new projects that has been ventured, we are investing on the testing part as well as the R&D part on a bit higher cost basis, because it is our beginning of the phase of both the plants.
So my concluding question to you will be, what is your manufacturing capacity and what is the company USP that sets you apart from other manufacturers?
So the manufacturing capacity currently stands at 400 megawatt for module manufacturing and 800 megawatt for EVA plant. Now, in terms of higher watt peak modules, once the plant has been set up, it will be 1 gigawatt of module manufacturing plant and around 1.2 gigawatt of EVA, because less EVA will be used in higher watt peak modules.
And what will be the company USP?
The company USP will be specifically, we have got the most automation that has been used by any other company in India. So due to that automation, what happens is the manual intervention is the least involved. And by lowering down the manual intervention, what will happen is that the solar cells will be very much secured and there will be very least micro cracks that will be developed, and the durability and longevity of the modules will be very high.
Okay. Thank you so much for all the time, and we wish you all the luck for your future endeavors. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.